It was a difficult morning for the former prisoners of war we met this week at Hellfire Pass in Thailand. Now, in their 90s, the veterans relived their struggle in the jungle at the very spot where they toiled on the death railway. Danielle Isdale is there.
When you attend a dawn service abroad, standing in a former battlefield where so many fought and died, it really is an incredible experience. So imagine what it's like for the veterans returning. There is an incredible group of former prisoners of war who helped to build the Thai-Burma railway here in Thailand, well, captured by the Japanese, who have come back to mark this Anzac Day. And they spent their mourning where they spent so many months 70 years ago, suffering at Hellfire Pass.
The shadows of prisoners cast by the glow of bamboo fires gave Hellfire Pass its name. 70 years on, the men who suffered here paused in the half-light once again to remember. Their thoughts with the almost 3,000 diggers who died building the death railway.
It does flash through one's mind, I think, more individually, of course, of those who were close to me and didn't get back.
So I think those thoughts are mine. Leave it at that.
I'm at peace.
Bob Goodwin, flanked by the sons of another POW who's now passed away, remembered his lost mate, Jack Boyd.
I had great pleasure in thinking about their dad. It's always with me.
Now, they're always with Bob.
Bob's been like a father.
Always proud of Bob. Wonderful.
It used to be that World War I veterans were the old men of our Anzac days, but now it's the World War II elderly diggers who are sharing their memories. It's only a matter of time, though, before they're gone too, but they hope their stories will live on.
Time catches up, you know.
But legends remain.
Thank you so much for saying hello. It's wonderful of you.
It's saying goodbye that's hard. At Hellfire Pass, Danielle Isdale, 10 News.